Welcome back to our study in the two letters Paul wrote to Timothy. We're in the second chapter of the first letter, and we learned in our last session how there is but one God. And there's only one way to get to that God, and that's through his only Son, Jesus Christ. And that's how we can have a right relationship with him, because Jesus Christ is God in the flesh. He lived a faultless, sinless, perfect life. And that's why he can be our ransom. We're going to pick up in verse 6, who gave himself as a ransom for all, the testimony born at the proper time. And for this I was appointed a preacher and an apostle. I am telling you the truth, I am not lying, as a teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. Paul, first of all, brings out the point that Christ is our ransom. He pays the debt for our sins. And he did that at just the right time. He goes on to say that he was appointed a preacher. And that same word translates as prophet. In other words, one who proclaims the truth. And an apostle, one who is sent with a specific message. And we see what that message and to whom he is sent with here in just a second. He says, I'm not lying to you. I'm telling you the truth here. As a teacher, as an instructor of the Gentiles. What's he instructing the Gentiles in? Obviously, faith and truth. And here is where Paul starts to realize his specific call is to the Gentiles. It's not to the Jews. Even though he is a Jew, he is a rabbi of rabbis, as we kind of hear him describe himself. He was taught and tutored by one of the best out there named Gamaliel. And that's a very interesting person to research in the book of Acts, too. But he instructs the Gentiles in faith and in truth. Jesus said in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. Exactly what Paul has been saying in these last couple of verses. We go on in verse 8. He says, therefore, I want the men in every place to pray, lifting up holy hands without wrath and dissension. Well, this is an interesting topic because some people will take this very literally and some people take this as a spiritual posture in prayer. Obviously, when someone is praying and or when someone is just in the room with you and they have their hands extended out, they are pretty defenseless, okay? They're humbled, okay? And that's a posture of humility before God, realizing that you are nothing and he is everything. And that's not to say we don't have any value. We do as children of God, Christians who live in the kingdom of God and work in the kingdom of God as God appoints us to. But when we come to him in prayer, bringing our needs, our burdens, our requests unto him, and when we come listening to him, we should come without any pretense. We should come without any defense. Without any dissension, as Paul says, we should come clean. And we should be willing to not only speak our heart honestly before God in humility, with our hands extended, or just doing that spiritually too. I don't see any real wrong in that either way. I grew up in a church where the men did raise their hands when they prayed out in the congregational prayer. And that was very interesting. It was not a charismatic or a Pentecostal community of faith, but that was a gesture they did, taking this scripture literally. But we can do it spiritually too, simply by humbling ourselves and our hearts before God. And when we do that, we come to him without any wrath, without any bitterness, without any dissension. We come clean and we pray. We let our requests be made known and then we listen. We want to hear his voice first and foremost. We'll pick up there in our next session.